Welcome to Algebra 1 CST release question number 15. Another good question here. I like these questions. Number 15 says the cost to rent a construction crane is $750 per day plus $250 per hour of use. Whew, that is pricey. You better be knowing what you're doing if you're going to get charged $250 an hour to use this construction crane. So what is the maximum number of hours the crane can be used each day if the rental cost is not to exceed $2,500 or $2,500 per day? So let's give these things some variables. Let's let C equal the total cost per day. C standing for cost. And let's go with H for the number of hours it's used per day. So H equals the hours used per day. With that in mind, now we can set up an equation to represent this scenario. So we have our total cost is going to equal, well, it's $750 right up front without even using it for a single minute. So $750 plus, and then $250 times the number of hours you use it for. This will represent our equation for the total cost in dollars. So our total cost is going to equal $750 plus $250 per hour, $250 times the number of hours. And so we're saying if it's not to exceed $2,500 or $2,500 per day. So if we're saying that that's true, it can't exceed that. That means the total cost at most can be $2,500. So $2,500, in other words, has to be greater than or equal to this other part. So the total cost equals that, but for our situation, we want to make sure we don't go over $2,500. We can actually equal it, we can't go over it. And so solving this for H is what I need to do to get my answer here. So subtract $750 from both parts, from both sides of the inequality. This will go away. Treat inequalities the same way as equations. The only difference is when you multiply or divide by a negative, you flip the sign. And so right here, we're just subtracting. We're not multiplying or dividing by a negative. And this will leave us with $1,750. And that would be $250 times H still here. If I divide both parts by $250, the $250 here will cancel with the $250 here like I want it to. I will have this is greater than or equal to H. And so we can't use the calculator on a CST. You might not be allowed to use a calculator on an Algebra 1 final or a test that you're doing. We should know how to do stuff like this without a calculator. Same number of zeros, very handy little tip here. You can cross off those same number of zeros. It's like dividing both parts by 10. And so it's still the same equivalent fraction, or still an equivalent fraction, just a much easier one to deal with. And then think of money here. This is a really good chance or situation to think of quarters in this case. How many quarters, 25 cents, how many quarters go into $1.75? Well, this would be 7. And so 7, or it looks like you could think of it as 7.0. I'll just think of it as 7 though. So 7 has to be the maximum that you can have for hours. 7 is greater than or equal to H. H represents your hours used per day. So you can use this no more. In other words, no more than 7 or 7.0 is the way they have it here, 7.0 hours. You can't go over that. Otherwise, you exceeded the value of $2,500 that maybe your company said you can't be spending more than this per day, $2,500 per day for that. So no more than 7 hours. Number 15 is choice C.